Hello, and welcome to Google Maps Developer Shortcuts. I'm Paul Saxman, and this week is our premiere episode of our shortcut series. We're going to try to teach tips, tricks, and techniques for building beautiful, compelling, useful maps in about 5 minutes or less. So that's actually, the show is 5 minutes or less. It might take you a couple minutes longer to get your map up and running, but that's the show. So with that, this week what we're going to do is we're going to talk about getting Google Drive data into a Google Map. And if we have time, we'll do the inverse, try to get a Google Map into Google Drive. So we can go both ways, one or the other, but let's start with the easy one. So if we go over to my spreadsheet here, you can see that I have a spreadsheet of about 10 cities. That's a column A. Column B, I have populations. And C and D is longitude and latitude. I got this data from the Natural Earth data set, which publishes all kinds of geographic data. We talked about in some previous shows. Getting that into Drive in this spreadsheet, you know, just a matter of cutting and pasting. If you have a lot more data, though, getting into Drive, you know, different techniques can apply. So, the technique here that I want to teach today is actually building a web service using Google Drive to serve this data to a map. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go over Tools and Script Manager. And you can see here I have a couple scripts already. If you don't have these scripts, which you won't, first time you run this, you just hit the new button. I'm going to say start with a, you can either start with a script as a web app or just a blank project. I'm going to start with blank project because actually building these web apps is really simple. And then you're ready to go actually editing your script. But I'm going to actually start with the one I already worked on. So you can see a few things here. I have a couple of constants at the top. The spreadsheet ID, that actually comes from over on my spreadsheet. If I close this window, that spreadsheet ID is actually in the browser bar up at the top. So you can copy that out for this script. Sheet name, this is called data. Actually, this is what I called the sheet here down at the bottom. By default, it's called sheet one or something like that. You just actually click on the little down arrow and rename it. These are two important steps, getting your key and getting your or naming your sheet. Next thing is you're going to want to create a doGet function and take a request object. So here I'm actually getting a using the request object, getting the parameters out, and getting JSON P, which is one of the parameters that I'm going to pass in later to this web service. So that is actually the callback that I'm passing into the web service. And here what I'm doing is actually getting the data out of my sheet. So here I'm using the spreadsheet app. Opening by ID, I'm taking the spreadsheet ID that I entered up here. Get sheet by name, I'm getting using data, which was the sheet that I named earlier. And get data range. So this is the range object now that I'm getting out of this call here. Next is I'm going to stringify into JSON the values from that spreadsheet. So here I'm doing range.getValues. I'm passing that into this JSON stringify method. And then I'm wrapping that in a JSONP function call. So I'm using my callback, which is the method I'm passing in, or will be passing into the request, and wrapping that in parentheses, because this is actually a function call, a JavaScript function call that I'll be using later. And very last line here, what I'm doing is I'm just taking that JSON output, creating this text output object, setting the MIME type to JSON, and returning from this doGet method. This down here is just some testing code. If you want to actually run this, you know, create a function like this to run it, you can get the output in the logs just for some eyeballs testing. Once you have this, you know, such a script together, the next thing you're going to want to do is go to File and Manage Versions. So what here is you're going to do is name a version for your application or for your or name your version and save a new version. So I didn't make any changes, so I'm not going to save a new one. You can see I have about five versions already, though, or I have had five versions already. But we'll close that. Once you've saved the version, you can go over to this little arrow here in the cloud, which is deploy as a web app, or you can also hit the publish button and also deploy as a web app. If you haven't already deployed it, I believe you just get the bottom part here. So you pick a project version, which was the version that we created earlier, executable as me, and what you're going to want to do is you're going to make anyone, even anonymous, can actually execute your app. Once you do this, be careful because once this is up and running, anybody can actually extract that data using this web service from your spreadsheet. So that's it. So once we do all those tricks, so let me go back here, deploy as a web app. I already have this running, but so I'm just going to say, give me my latest code. You can see that I get a URL here, and this actually returns the data in JSON in my spreadsheet. Here I'm getting undefined because I didn't actually pass in pass in the JSON P. Very last thing, so you're going to want to copy this script line out here, because this is what you're actually going to paste into your map code. Now I'm going to go over to some map code. I'm going to paste in this data services URL, which was the one that I just made, or that I just copied out. I'm going to add a JSON P parameter. So this is the callback function. So callback is actually my JSON P callback in my map JavaScript. I'm initializing a map here. Here's a little tricky bit. So after I've initialized the map, I'm actually going to create a script tag, pass in the data services URL, which is the URL to this web service that's running in Google Drive. And then I'm actually going to append this object to the head of my DOM tree. And that's actually going to execute the script that this JSON, it's actually going to call the JSON P service. And then I have a callback function. I'm getting the data back. This is just we saw the JSON before. It's actually just an array of an array. So I'm actually creating a marker for each of the lat long points that are in this spreadsheet. That's pretty much it. So and then there's a little bit of map canvas code down here. So it's a very simple application. And if we go over to what the end product looks like, I'm just running this on locally. So if I reload this, this is the code that I just showed a minute ago. You can see all these points rendered on a map from Google Drive. Just proof of concept, if I go back over here and let's say I want to get rid of all but one of these, I could just delete those out, save, spreadsheet saved. I go back to my awesome map, I reload it, and all I have is Japan now. So this is a great way you can create dynamic data or create a spreadsheet, share it with other people. They can actually change the data, dynamically change in the map. Really great use case there. I'm out of time, so today I'm not going to cover actually getting your Google Map into Google Drive, but we'll cover that in another episode. So if you have any questions about the show, if you have any other ideas for future shows, let me know. And just post them in the comments of the YouTube stream or on Google+. With that, we'll see you next week.